Hi everyone, today we're going to be talking about what a function is and why they are important to us in math. A function is essentially a relationship between a given input, which we typically call x, to one specific output, which we typically call y. Therefore, for a given function, let's say x squared, we can input any x value we want, that is, within our domain, which we will talk about in the next video, and we will only ever get one output value back. This creates what we call an ordered pair, which means that every x value, which remember is our input, has only one possible output of the function, and this will never change. So, if we wanted to represent our function graphically, we can create a table of values given several inputs. This table should make it more clear about the ordered pair idea. As we can see here, we know x squared is a function as every input, no matter what we enter, will only ever give a single answer, no matter what. We can also represent the function graphically using the ordered pairs, which is easiest to do once our table of input and output values is created. One thing many students do not realize is that you can have multiple y values that are the same. The problem is, if your one input, your x value, were to give you multiple outputs, then we would no longer have a function. We will deal with this in a much later calculus course, though. Functions are typically represented in several ways, but they all mean the same thing. Firstly, we could have f of x, which just means that the value f of x is a function, so remember, one input to one output, for the input variable x. This is the same thing as saying y equals something. So f of x is y, as there are two different ways to represent the output or product of our function given a certain input. So, in summary, just remember that a function is essentially the relation between an input to a single output. If your input, remember that is your x value, gives you more than one possible y value, then you no longer have a function. So let's look at these four tables here. Which two do you think are functions and which two are not? Well, since we can see two outputs for a single input in both tables 1 and table 4, then we know both these tables violate our function rule of only one output per input. Therefore, they are not representative of functions. However, tables 2 and 3 do represent a function, as every unique input only has one single output. Lastly, let's do a test on these four graphs here. Which one of these four graphs represents a function and which three do not? What do you think? Well, if we place a vertical line on a graph of a function, it'll only ever hit one output for a single input. Therefore, since graphs 1, 3, and 4 all hit our vertical line multiple times for some given input, it is clear that only graph 2 is a function, the rest are not. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.